Come on, put your hands together, guys. Put your hands together, let's love him. wonderful, marvelous, he is, almighty, incredible, amazing, supernatural, that wonderful, marvelous, he is, almighty, incredible, amazing, supernatural, that wonderful, marvelous. Supernatural, he's wonderful, marvelous, he is, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Whoa, yeah, almighty, incredible, amazing, supernatural, so wonderful, marvelous, he is, almighty, incredible, amazing, supernatural, he's wonderful, marvelous, he is, almighty, incredible, supernatural, it's wonderful, marvelous, he is, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, amen. Have you found him be wonderful today? Amen. Have you found him be marvelous today? Amen. He is our healer today. He is our deliverer today. Amen. 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 I'm glad to be in the house of the healer. I'm glad to be in the presence of the deliverer today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. With all honor today, I'd like to bring to this pulpit Brother Dennis Lewis. He has impacted so many people's lives. Amen. A powerhouse in the ministry today. And I know that God has a word for our church. Amen. I know that God has a word for our church. Amen, Brother Lewis.
Thank you, Pastor, and praise the Lord, everybody. I give honor to Pastor Nichols and First Lady, brothers and sisters. We serve a mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Somebody say hallelujah. 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 Eromosete de Bohori Mamanda Sasha. Urre bababando se che tele beyondo de bohura babata sai. No remande che tele boho se te yeya. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We sent you, O Lord. In your presence, there's fullness of joy. At your right hand, there's pleasures forevermore. I feel your healing. spirit in this place. Hallelujah. Mighty, 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 mighty God. Just reach out. You know He's here. Reach out in faith. Bring healing in the name of Jesus. Bring healing in the name of Jesus to every sick temple, body. Hallelujah. Breathe healing up over the bodies of people that are suffering right now. Breathe healing in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to God. This is what we fast and pray for right here, right now. What we do in secret in our prayer time, in our fasting time, He rewards us openly in His presence that all can be ministered to. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my Lord, there is a presence. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Woo. Ah. Thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. You're a healing Jesus.
In the house right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If everybody could stand to your feet.
Hallelujah. 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 Spirit of the Lord's moving out here in the pews. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you'll get your Bibles and turn with me to Joshua, the first chapter. The first verse. Now, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that they spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise. Go over this Jordan, and thou and all this people unto the land which I do give them, even to the children of Israel. Final reading, Isaiah 43. Isaiah 18:19-20. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The beast of the field shall honor me. The dragons and the owls, because I give waters in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to give drink to my people, my chosen. You will find my message in the 18th verse. And the 19th. Behold, I will do a new thing. Behold, I will do a new thing. Before we pray, I'd like to thank, I have some friends here today. Sister Patsy Johnson, hallelujah. Sister Gloria, the Petries, thank you so much for coming. I paused because the Lord was sending my mind to another direction. We don't have to work this up. It's here. It is here right now. In a special way, open up and let Him change your life for the next few minutes. Take 30 seconds, raise your hands. If you think He is a good God, I want you to give Him praise accordingly. If He has blessed you, I want you to give Him praise accordingly. Hallelujah! Oh, thank you, Jesus, Son of the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God bless your heart. You can be seated. In Isaiah 43:18, he said, "Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing, and it shall spring forth." Hallelujah. And it shall spring forth. God wants to do a new thing in your life. You must leave your past behind in order to move into your future. You have to be determined. Your mind has to be made up that I am not going to judge my future by my past. But because he said, I will do a new thing. Brand new. Hallelujah. 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 There are times in your life that you just have to simply look at your past and say, hasta la vista, baby, and give it a kiss goodbye. You have to make up in your mind that you are sorry for the wrong in the past and ready to move into a new place in God. Moses, as I read, represented the old way of doing things. He had to die so that the children of Israel could begin a new life. You cannot go to the promised land the same way of thinking and doing things. That is why the Lord said, "Behold, I will do a new thing." Setbacks tend to keep you in the past. Have you ever noticed that you can have your life all planned out? Everything set in order. And suddenly God will slip in and mess every bit of it up. And we are amazed. Why did he mess it up? As I have said before, if you want him to bless you in the promise, he's got to be able to bless you in the process. You'll never get to your destiny without going through the process first. Somebody shout amen. Hallelujah. Setbacks can keep you in the past. Hallelujah. The children of Israel were full of hope and faith, and all of a sudden, their leader dies. Moses. They were at the point of victory when one of their greatest setbacks took place. The man in whom they loved, and they loved him. God, let me pause. God had to move him off of the scene. Another message, another day I could preach. Because he failed to sanctify God when God told him, after telling him, strike the rock and water will come forth. The second time God said, speak to the rock. Instead of speaking, he casually struck the rock again. God told him because of that disobedience. He said, you will not enter the land that flows with milk and honey. You will see it from afar. God is detailed. God expects obedience to the very detail as he has spoken it. The Bible said obedience is better than sacrifice. God moved Moses off of the scene before they could enter their future. Hallelujah. Aaron, his brother, was a part of that judgment that came to Moses. He was a part of it. He said, Aaron's going to join his ancestry. Take him up to the mount where I tell you. Take his cloak off of him. Give it to his son. The transference of the anointing went over to Aaron's son. We've got to find out. It was the same anointing. I said it was the same anointing. But obedience must be if his son intended to see the works of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can have your life all planned out. They were set back when Moses died. Hallelujah. Have you ever said, why, Lord, me? God, have I not been living right? Why did this have to happen to me? You were not in sin. Your faith seemed to be working. Paying your tithes, your offerings. And suddenly, if it wasn't work, if it wasn't your job, it was your spouse. If not your spouse, it was your family or closest friend. Before a major breakthrough in your life comes, the devil will fight you the hardest. He wants to impede your progress. He wants to set you back into depression. He wants to take every weapon you have and shut it down. Hallelujah. But I will count it all joy when I fall into divers temptations, that the trying of my faith worketh patience. God's not going to always leave you in the trial. There is going to be a time if you pass the course. You will have your PhD in trouble before you come out of the University of Hard Knocks. And if you don't have your PhD, he's going to keep you in there a little longer, because we don't want to have to repeat the course through disobedience. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. He said, it's about to spring up. Touch your neighbor and say, it's about to be set loose. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before a major breakthrough, the devil will fight you the hardest. The darkest night is just before the dawn. If you're going through a storm today, it just means something good is fixing to happen in your life. Mark 4:36 tells us about the disciples crossing the Red Sea and a storm arose. They were confronted with a decision. Do we go on and turn back? Do we have a setback? Or do we keep pressing forward? You have a decision to make. He has declared, behold, I will do a new thing. You have to decree, am I going to turn back to get some rest? I can't take this resistance. That's your decision. As far as he's concerned, he said, I'm doing a new thing. But that new thing is going to be found in your future. It's not going to be living in your past, because your past can do nothing. Matter of fact, you need to quit reminding God in your prayer time, always repenting of the past. He don't know what you're talking about, so quit trying to remind him. He's not hearing you in that context. It is impossible for him to remember. He cannot remember repented sins. He has spiritual amnesia. When you repent, he said it is thrown into the sea of forgetfulness. It means just what it says. Forgetfulness.
You might take a little advice from that and turn your prisoners loose.
Hallelujah.
I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. What better example than the daddy and the mother of us all? He said, I don't dwell under the blood. What is under the blood is under the blood, and I have no ability to go back under the blood and drag it back out. Ladies and gentlemen, there will be no redo at Calvary. He hung on the cross and he said, it is finished. When he said it is finished, he meant it is finished. I can come boldly under the throne of grace. Hallelujah. I can come boldly because he has gone and he said, it is finished. Somebody raise your hands and shout amen. But if you'll keep pressing forward, as they got across, a man with demons met them. A great miracle took place when Jesus cast them out. They went a little further and met Jairus' daughter, who was dead. Jesus raised her from the dead. Behold, I will do a new thing. She went from death to life. Oh, hallelujah to God. Some of you are living in dead situations, but the Lord is about to give you a wake-up call. He's about to ring your doorbell and say, I would like to do a new thing today. Hallelujah. The lady with the issue of blood, 12 years going to doctors, running from one clinic to the next, spent every dime she had, and they could not figure out how to fix the problem. But, oh, hallelujah, the new thing come to town. And she said in her heart, if I can but touch the hem of his garment, oh, glory to God, the old shall pass away. The bleeding shall stop. Somebody get happy with me. Hallelujah. The bleeding shall stop. And some of you that are hemorrhaging, in the name of Jesus Christ, it's about to stop. And the Lord is about to get some glory. She touched the hem after she got into the press. We want him to come deliver everything to our bedside. It is not going to work that way. We just want him to pamper us, bringing us. No, 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 no. If you want it, he said, you have access. You can come on into the throne room of grace. You can come in there and you can have me personally and you can be in my presence personally and I can fix the old thing and turn it into a new thing. But you're going to have to comply through obedience. People don't want to obey. They want to do it their way. Hallelujah, you're not going to be able to have Burger King religion. Have it your way. No, it's going to be his way or the highway. If you want the treasures that he possesses, you're going to do it the way he says do it. And he said if we would obey, he said it will spring forth immediately. It's going to come up and you will go away rejoicing. Somebody say hallelujah. Sometimes we can pray and fast and still not get the answer we're looking for.
But that's when true faith says, I'm going on with God. Some people refuse to bury the dead things in their life. They leave them like dead corpses lying around on the top of the ground till they stink. God said, today, it's time to bury the past failures and disappointments, all of the setbacks. As I pray, it's about to turn into a setup. Oh, glory. You got to come out of it. You got to invite the blood of Jesus to possess you. Failures, disappointments. He said, it shall be changed. It shall go. And behold, I will do a new thing. It's time to bury the sin in your past and all the mistakes and go on with your life. Cover them in the blood of Jesus Christ. I mean, cover them, and when it comes back to harass you again, start pleading the blood all over again. It's not going to be long, hallelujah, and the enemy is going to flee because the devil cannot handle the blood of Jesus. If we allow them, there are certain things in your past that will hold you back from going forward. We must turn loose of all the past, all rejection, all hurt. If we hang around dead situations long enough, we will act dead. Old memories are like a pair of old shoes. You would like to throw them away, but they just can't do it. They feel so comfortable. You've had them for so long. But you must get rid of those dead things in order to have a new life. It's time to get out the shovel. Pronounce the last eulogy over your past. Take that shovel and bury it in the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. I said, oh, hallelujah. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. We are not left without God's promise of a new thing. We have the word of God to stand on. Hallelujah, that when we put the past behind us, the Lord will give you a brand new future. Somebody shout amen. It's like a new chapter in the book of your life. Something fresh, not old. The beginning of the greatest days, hallelujah, in your walk with God. Knowing that he will never leave you or forsake you. That he is always with us. That is the rock that we stand on. Behold. I want to do a new thing. A brand new thing. But you cannot get to the future hanging on to old memories. Preserving old memories that have been painful, hurtful. Take it out and say the scripture is life. The scripture is freedom. The scripture will lift the burden. The scripture will bring peace and joy. Many have the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. That That's all wonderful, and that is all good, and that is the command. But it's useless if you don't have the joy of the Holy Ghost and you don't have the peace of God that passeth all understanding. If you're always stressed out, always angry, always frustrated, you can hide behind speaking in tongues, but the real you, you will go to bed with it every night. And the real you can be joy unspeakable and full of glory. Or the real you can be living in your past miseries. The Lord said, behold, you feel that? Behold, I'm about to do a new thing in your home. Oh, hallelujah. I said, behold, I will do a new thing in your home. You just got to start prophesying it through tongues. You just got to get up every day and start speaking to it. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. In Acts 19 they did it. They spake with tongues and prophesied. Oh, hallelujah. They foretold. He said, a new thing's coming to your house. Rejoice, because every time symptoms stick their head up, you speak to the symptom. Hallelujah. I'm going to say it again. Symptoms are not the verdict. Symptoms come so you can take the written word of God and speak in faith and tear that strong, oh hallelujah, tear that stronghold down. You say, I've prayed for my children, I have fasted, and it just seems like nothing turns them around. That's just a symptom. Take the fullness of God if you can get to that level and go prophesy out of that situation and say, symptom, you're not my verdict. You just came to pester me, harass me. I want you to come a little closer, symptom, because I want to preach to you. I want to preach to you about the blood. I want to preach to you about the word. I want to preach to you about the name of Jesus, symptom. I want to speak this name to you. I want to introduce this Jesus to you, symptom. Somebody say hallelujah. You don't have to work up a big to-do in order to say God touched. I know that 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 I know when I stepped in this podium a while ago, he was here. Your faith has to activate. You can sit back and wait for a preacher to lay hands on you, and you're wanting him to give you his gifting. But God said, I've got a new thing specially designed for you that I built out of your crisis. I took the pieces of your crisis, and I have built my glory. You got to go get it. You got to celebrate it. You got to dance around it. You got to praise around it. You got to get your praise on, ladies and gentlemen. You have to make the conscious decision. Oh, I can lay here and sulk. I can lay here and be depressed from here on out. But I choose to accept a new thing. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. Hallelujah. As musicians come. Don't always make a decision that God has done something for you by feeling. He spoke to me some years ago because I got thrown off because one service in revival would be so much more powerful than the other service, or it wasn't like the last services. He's not a one-trick pony. He moves different all the time. He's got new things to give. And he told me, he said, when you lay hands on people, do not in your spirit always judge it by what you feel. Because what you feel does not mean that I'm doing or not doing the work. He said, just lay hands on them in faith and go on praising me and rejoicing. Symptoms are not the verdict. There's always residuals with us earthlings. There's going to always be weakness in the flesh. But you got to keep working on that relationship. You got to keep living in obedience. You got to keep walking with the Lord. And He will heal you every day. He will minister to you every day. Raise our hands right now. We're coming to the altar call. Do not let that faith of yours, don't let it leave.